so much it's going to run you short for the wedding, but just...
Thank you. be seated. The three institutions, the church and the state and the home, the oldest and most sacred is the home. We notice that God himself instituted it in the time of man's innocency in the garden, where he chose for man a woman, a helpmate. It's so appropriate for us to realize that God took from man's side a rib, as in companionship, not from his head to be lorded over or his feet to be trampled upon, but from his side. And those two would become then one flesh. As Ephesians, the sixth chapter, tells us, wives should submit themselves to their husbands. And it also says that husbands should love their wives, as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. And then in the whole essence of Ephesians, the sixth chapter, it talks about that this union is the same union, mystically, as Christ is with the church. And so as these two have come today, we're challenged and charged with the idea that two become one flesh and one heart. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother died.
Tell us that a man will leave his father and mother and will be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. We know that there are days of adjustment ahead, not only for Steve and Becky, but for you as parents as well. Do you promise to pray for them and accept the fact that from this time forward they are one and have need? And will you promise to accept each Steve and Becky as your own son and daughter and offer words of encouragement to enhance the relationship together?
We will.
Will you please come and light the candle that represents the life of your child?
Children would leave us and begin to build a home.
Steve, will you have Becky to be your wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Becky, will you have Steve to be your husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you obey him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live? Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. I dare to pledge you my love.
I dare to pledge you my love.
Rebecca, it's your full intent to take Steve as your husband. Please repeat these words. I, Rebecca Lee Kitchell, take you, Stephen Todd McIntyre, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, and to obey till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, I dare to give you my love.
Stephen, Becky, throughout Scripture, God has always dealt in covenants with his people. We also deal in covenants with one another. Very much as Noah received the rainbow, also we present those same symbols and covenants to one another. Steve, today what is your symbolic covenant with Becky that she may wear it and people may behold it that you exchange these vows? And the ring that Steve places upon her finger is of a very precious metal, very symbolic of that relationship, of the preciousness of the relationship. And also, it's a circle, unbroken and enduring. Steve, take the ring and place it upon her finger with this vow. By this ring, and this act, I declare before these witnesses, that you will be my beloved wife.
That you will be my beloved wife.
And I will be your faithful husband. Becky, what symbol do you have to give to him to show that your vow is enduring and symbolic? And just as well, the ring that she places upon Steve's finger is of the preciousness of the metal and enduring of its symbolism. Becky, with this, repeat this pledge.
By this ring
and this act, I declare before these witnesses, I will be your beloved wife, and you will be my faithful husband.
Every day.
Steve and Becky have also chosen to sign their marriage certificate in the presence of all of you as part of their ceremony. And then they have a special gift for their parents.
This is only the beginning. So much lies ahead. I hope that you're this is only the beginning, so much lies ahead, so I hope that you'll remember all the words that Jesus said. He said a house that is divided can never stand alone, but a life that's built on Jesus' love is never gonna fall. Yeah.
Let's pray together. Father, I thank you for Steve and Becky. I thank you for this moment of their beginning together. I just ask now that as they have come and shared vows and rings, and as they have asked you personally as their Lord and Savior to be the center, the foundation of their life, I just ask that you'll bless them in everything. Father, that upon this foundation, upon your rock, their entire relationship and the rest of their lives together will be built. And Father, I thank you for Steve and his call to your service. And for Becky now, together as one, I just ask now that you'll guide and direct their every step, that you'll give them wisdom every day, and Father, that you'll bind their hearts together as they grow in you and grow together with one another. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Stephen and Rebecca have consented together in holy wedlock and witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring and by joining hands, I pronounce that you are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Steve, you may kiss your bride.
question. Do you want to do that? We need to set it somewhere.
No, we need another close-up of a kiss.
I'll take care of it. Hey, come on.
Here. Alan, I need to help you with this.
Oh,
you kind of hold that.
That was
oh, like you didn't mind.
I didn't mind, but pictures. Gotta love pictures.
Well, hello.
Well.
appreciate him more because I got rid of him. You won't be calling me every night because you'll have somebody else to talk to. I'll probably be calling him. So he's a good friend. I love him. And I wish him the best of luck in life.
Thank you.
can't keep you waiting.
Good job.
Good job.
You are fine.
Thanks.
That's good.
Step in front of you, did I?
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you. Pin it up. I can't do this.
Yes.
Hey, Steve, show us some of those layup shots now.
Huh?
Show us some layup shots. Charging. Everything's okay. Power's on.
Okay.
Just want to let you guys know. You're all invited. Alan Bell is the next one that's going to get married. So you give it a few years.
Julie. Julie. Hi, Julie. We need one of you doing that to her.
That was for their picture.
Mine was better.
Yours was better, yes.
Pictures. They're taking some more.
Thank you.
see what it looks like?
Yeah, I'll try to figure out how to let you guys. Standing right here behind him. Kind of like we come in. You guys like this?
Okay. So we need to arrange right
actually,
here.
Actually, we can do that.
I'm doing this.
And there goes Oscar without the tuxedo on.
Yeah. This camera doesn't flash when I think it should. Wait a second. Let me get that.
Didn't flash there either, did it?
It seems to think that it can. Oh, that went off.
Yeah.
Bad flash. Wait there.
I noticed it looked awful bright. Nope.
What do we have to do now?
Well, we gotta take some more pictures.
Got outside,
two. Basketball.
Yes. Yeah, that's unlocked. She left it unlocked.
I know, because you've got hiking me. I know.
Which time I looked at that.
Well, there she goes. Get out of the gown. She just doesn't want to look at us. There she is.
Have they left?
Listen, Rod, get in here and clean up the kitchen.
What?
Right now. Go clean the kitchen up. Get in here and clean up the kitchen.
No, this is a good excuse. I like this.
It doesn't hold water.
We're going to have to do everything today because church is tomorrow.
I'm doing good.
Mom?
He's getting tired of all us boys picking on him.
Mom, do you have the keys? I want to get rid of some of this stuff in your car.
Steven, I want to go home and grab that.
There she is.
Tell him about the
picture.
We're ready
to
get in the car.
Becky, juice. Becky.
Okay.
I just got permission from the
Okay, you ready?
Gotcha.
I was thinking
of trying to get out of here.
Marked on. Rod, what study parked on?
I'm just going to leave the rest of the stuff sitting up in
here. Thank you.
Let's go back. Let's go right back.
Bye, bye. I will see you when you get back.
Bye-bye. I'm just going to leave this stuff here.
No more turning the lights off and on.
Yes!
No more. No, no, no.
Now you can kiss her, Steve.
Hello. We need
more. I'll honestly quit saying, quit that.
Are you going to drive it up and pick us up and then open the doors for us?
Yeah. Sure. But I won't guarantee you that I won't tell you to quit being mushy. You guys quit being mushy.
Can't guarantee that we'll listen, though.
I didn't think you would.
Cool.
It's still on my leg.
How'd you get blood on your leg?
I can't believe that.
This is all I'm taking.
Hold on, hold on.
Couldn't get
that.
Well, oops. I watched it off.
I can't see where I'm going, you know.
Well, you backed up. Put on your backup lights.
You have to watch out for me.
No, wait, so I can do this.
Now,
yeah,
if I can.
Oh, the car started.
Can I get out for a second to get for a hug?
Yeah, my car started. I just had to be nice. Okay. Now, if I can come to your way,
you'd
be able to. Yeah, but you're the best man. You're supposed to be nice. Let's go.
Hey, where's the bird park?
Wait here. Grab it.
Yeah. I got your ring box. You have my ring box. Okay, you're not bringing any of your stuff.
Hey, what?
I gotta go.
Thank you.
Yeah,
more
brother.
The floorboard on the side as well. Take
okay.
Push forward then.
Yeah, sure.
I want to
break. Hold on, kid. Go ahead and get in. I'm going to get caught up here.
Is this the other side of the sled or is the other side west of the sled?
No, both sides of it. We're being fair.
Where
did
that go?
Go ahead and get in, and I'm just going to ask you.
Hi. Hi. I can't get you right that way.
Okay, you guys lean forward for a minute. Hey. Bye.
Bye.
They want me to leave.
Work out fine.
Okay, fade out.